I just figured I'd come down and see how you are, Richie.
Those guys in circulation are driving me crazy. Come on in here, the doc. I need you, Frank. I don't think them guys can read, much less count, for crying out loud.
I am glad you showed up.
You got problems?
Problems, you might say that. The man is talking hitting.
Details.
Oh, well, I'm trying to make this place run a little bit efficient, you know? So I've got some ideas, but Frank thinks I'm trying to steal his job. So I just wish you'd talk to him, Fonz.
No.
Ah, thanks. No?
Why'd you take this job?
You know why I took it. I was trying to make some extra money. You know, I wanted to buy that neat coat.
Why do you think Frank is here?
Well, I...
Food, rent. Maybe he's got a wife at home with babies.
Yeah, but Fonz...
Hey, look, this could be his whole life, right? You're making him nervous. I'd be nervous, too, if some bright-eyed, bushy-tailed college kid came in here trying to change everything right away.
Well, I'm only trying to make things better.
If a man is hanging from his fingertips, you don't want some guy walking over his cuticles.
Maybe I was being a little pushy.
Yeah, and he's pushing back.
What can I do about it now?
You show him that you can be a team member before you're a star.
Now you see what I'm talking?
I think I'm starting to get the idea.
I think you're doing great.
Hey, Fonz, would you come over and meet Frank?
Yeah, lead the way.
Frank, I'd like you to meet a good friend of mine, the Fonz. Fonz, this is Frank.
I read your paper.
Thanks. Don't you work at Bronco's Garage?
Yeah, that's right. What do you drive?
51 Chevy.
My favorite.
Hey, I never knew that.
I've been needing a fuel pump lately, but I'm a little short.
You can always work something out.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You can always work something out.
Thanks. If you ever need your newspaper a little early.
I can dig it. I can dig it. Listen, you guys got some work to do. I'm going to take off, right? Pretty soon you're going to be upstairs right in the store.
Thanks, Fonz.